Hi students, let us continue with the subject computer organization and architecture. In the previous video I explained about the bus architecture. Now let us see the bus arbitration. So what is this bus arbitration? So the bus architecture consisting of system bus, so which consists of data bus, address bus and control bus. Then what about this arbitration? Arbitration is nothing but it is deciding who get access to the bus for reading or writing. For any transaction, who gets access? So that will be decided by the arbitration. So why we need arbitration? Actually, a multiple devices may need to use the bus at the same time. Okay, so a bus will be there. So a bus will be connected to a multiple devices. So, multiple devices or may need to use the bus at the same time. So, must have to, we have, this has, the bus has to decide which device has to be handed the bus first. Okay, means the bus arbitration is going to be decide. So, which device has to be served first. Okay, so that is the master. The bus arbitration is nothing but it is a master. It is deciding so which device has to be accessed first, which data has to be take first. Okay, all the data cannot be take at a time. Only one device can be served at one time. So for that we need some bus arbitration. The bus arbitration scheme usually try to balance. Let me write that. Bus arbitration scheme usually try to balance the bus priority. It try to balance the bus priority and fairness. So this bus arbitration will do these two things. Means it bus priority means which the highest priority has to be served first. After that the lowest priority. So like that. So based on this, this bus arbitration will be decided. And the fairness means whether it is giving service to all the devices or not. So that will be decided by the fairness. So this bus arbitration scheme usually try to balance bus priority and the fairness. So there are three mechanisms, arbitration mechanisms are there. Three arbitration mechanisms. So means the deciding of a bus, means serving a device, those can be done by using three arbitration mechanisms. So those are daisy chain mechanism, and polling is one mechanism, and independent request. Actually these three mechanisms each uses a special control lines for each arbitration. So whatever the arbitration they are doing, each prefers some special control lines. These having some special control lines, this is having some special, and this is also for special control lines. So the main aim of this bus three arbitration mechanism is to serve the device based on the priority. Okay, it has to serve based on the priority, but each having their own rules. So let us discuss one by one. So the first one is daisy chain. Daisy chain arbitration. So what is this daisy chain arbitration? So actually the deciding can be done by only the master. So whatever the system you have taken, every system is having only one master. Okay. Suppose if you are here only one master is there. Like that means whatever you are doing in the system or every component is having one master. Just like that, the bus arbitration is having only one master, the bus master. Bus master, and here let take three devices D1, D2, D3 or three devices, and these three devices is having connected to bus request, bus busy and bus grant. So this is a daisy chain mechanism. So what here, what it's doing? So first, whenever the bus request, it's sending the bus request to the master, bus master. The bus master first it checks the, means whenever the bus is free, whenever the bus is free means it is not sending any data or anything, means no device is taking the bus. So the bus request is sent to the bus master. So the bus master first asks the highest priority, checks the highest priority device. So D1 is here the highest priority and D3 is the lowest priority. So the bus master first grant the bus grant signal to the D1. So whenever the D1 is ready to take the bus, first it takes that bus and it sends the busy signal. So whenever the bus grant is taken, it sends a busy on the bus so that no other devices can ask for bus grant. So after the completion of it, it sends a signal to the next device, bus grant. So after this work is over, it releases the bus. Whenever it releases the bus, the D2 will take the bus request. So like that, after completion of one, the D2 will take. After that, D3 will take. So this is a daisy chain process, one after other. So this is one mechanism, bus arbitration mechanism. So what are the advantages here? It is very simple to construct. This is advantage. And coming to the disadvantage, advantage is simple. Disadvantage. So the disadvantages here is it cannot assure fairness. Cannot assure fairness. Why it is cannot assure fairness? Because a low priority device may be locked out indefinitely. Okay, suppose it is a low priority device, it may be locked indefinitely until all the high priority devices are served. Means it is checking each device whether it is you need a bus or not, you need a bus or not, like that. So that it, whenever it comes to the last, means some other highest priority device may come in middle, okay, and join here. So it cannot assure any fairness. A low priority device has to be locked indefinitely. And one more disadvantage is it is slower. Why it is slower? Because daisy chain grant signal limits the bus speed. It always limits the bus speed. So this is about the daisy chain. Now coming to the second mechanism. What is the second mechanism? Pooling. So what is this pooling? So it's just like daisy chain, but only the difference is here you don't have the bus grant directly. Here the bus master will decide which device has to be served first. Bus master, and here devices will be there D1, D2, D3. Okay, and here these lines, three lines will be there here. One is for polling, sorry, POLLING, not POO, POLLING, polling, bus request, bus busy. Whenever any device is using the bus, it sends the bus busy signal in this line. So here, okay, so this is a polling. Here the bus master, means the line grant specifies with set of polling lines. So this is a line grant, it specifies a set of lines. So let me write the steps for this. So first what it does, if bus not busy, suppose if the bus is not busy, make bus request. Okay, ask for bus request. Make bus request to the master. So it is asking bus request to the master. Now, in the second step, the master. So here the master. The master polls means the master is decides by checking each device which is having the highest priority. Means it is not serving line by line. So in the daisy chain, one after other it is checking. But here the bus master will check each device which is having highest priority by placing device ID on polling lines. So just on these lines, the bus master will assign some divide IDs. So each device is having one ID. So based on the ID, the master will decide which device has to be served first. Maybe first it has to be served. Maybe it has to be served. Means the everything will be decided by the bus master. Okay. So after that, if device gets busy, sorry, if device gets bus grant, mark bus busy. So these are the steps you have to follow for the polling. And let us see what are the advantages and disadvantages in polling arbitration. So advantages is, only thing is, no disadvantages whatever that are present in daisy chain. No disadvantage of daisy chain. What are the disadvantages in daisy chain? Why we going for polling? The disadvantage in daisy chain is it is no fairness will be there and it is slower. Why it is not fairness? Because each device assigns an I. In the daisy chain, each device has to be checked. So the lowest priority device may has to be wait indefinitely. So that is the disadvantage in daisy chain. But whereas in polling, because of each device assigns an ID, so the device cannot wait indefinitely. Compulsory the device has to be served. So based on the master's decision, that is the advantage in polling. And coming to the disadvantage is, here some extra poll lines you required, whereas in the daisy chain only one grant line will be there, but here extra poll lines should require. And here also the polling is delay, just like a bus grant, polling is delay. Now coming to the third mechanism, that is independent request. So here the name itself is saying each device is independent to each other. Independent request. So what it means? Bus master is there and the devices D1, D2. I'm taking three devices, D3. So now here each device is requesting independently, R1. So whenever it is ready, it sends the grant signal, G1. Again this device requesting, R2. So whenever the bus is free, the master is sending grant signal, G2. And the D3 is requesting for the bus, for the master. The master is granting the bus signal to the D3. So here bus busy. So this is independent request. Each device is requesting the bus master. Whenever the bus is busy, the device has to be wait until the bus is released. So whenever this operation is over, it releases the bus, then the bus master will send the grant request to the D1 device. So each here devices are requesting. Okay, each device is requesting the bus master for requesting for the bus. So whenever the bus is free, then only the master will send the bus grant signal to the devices. So it's also based on the priority only. And here the steps are, if bus not busy, make bus request. And the master decides who to grant access. The master is deciding who to grant bus. access based through grant lines. And here the if device gets bus grant marked as a bus busy. So whenever it is taking the bus, it has to mark bus busy. Whenever it is using, it has to mark bus busy. After operation is over, you just mark it as bus release. So here the advantages in independent request is fast, dynamic priority is possible. Dynamic priority is possible. And what is the disadvantage here? The main disadvantage is here, we require 2N lines for N devices. Because for request and grant, two more lines has to be required. If you are using N devices, you require 2N lines. For each device, 1N, 2N. So, 2N lines for N devices. So, this is about the three mechanisms of bus arbitration: daisy chain, polling, and independent request. Thank you.